Genesis chapter 25, we see something very interesting in Abraham's life now. Now, Abraham marries again. Sarah has passed away. He marries. In verse 1, we see Abraham took another wife whose name was Keturah. Now, remember, Abraham is a pretty old man at this point. And he takes another wife whose name is Keturah. She bore him Zimran, Joshan, Medan, Midian, Ishbak, and Shua. Okay, that is 6 sons. 6 more sons. So Abraham has had 8 children. He had Ishmael first with Hagar. He had Isaac, the child of promise, through whom God promised to bless him and make him a blessing to the nations, all peoples. And then here, Keturah, he has 6 more children. And then it begins to go on through the descendants here. These sons also were the sons of different clans. These sons were also the founders of different clans. Verse 3, Joshan fathered Sheba and Dedan. The sons of Dedan fathered Ashurim, Leshuim, and Lumumim, if I'm pronouncing these correctly. Verse 4, the sons of Midian were Ephah, Epher, Hanok, Abida, and Elda. All these were children of Keturah. Abraham gave all he had to Isaac, but to the sons of his concubines, Abraham gave gifts. And while he was still living, he sent them away from Isaac eastward to the east country. And the days of the years of Abraham's life were 175 years. So we see Abraham has other children. We also have some highlights of the descendants of some of his sons. And we see that Abraham gives them gifts and sends them away to the east. And these sons will be fathers of different tribes, and some of them will develop into nations that endure. If not all of them, that endure to a degree. But Abraham kept Isaac as his heir. Now it's interesting, this also appears to happen after Isaac has taken a wife. Isaac has taken his wife Rebekah, and now Abraham, his dad, gets remarried and begins to have children and then sends them away. It's kind of interesting. Here your son is just getting married, and then you're getting remarried and having all these kids. And the interesting thing we see with Isaac is that Rebekah will struggle with barrenness. She will only have 2 sons, twins. It will appear in a sense that God may be slow on fulfilling his promise again. I mean, how long did Sarah and Abraham wait for Isaac, and they tried to do things their own way, and they got Hagar in the mix and tried to have a surrogate mother to fulfill God's plan? Isaac, though, there will be a difference. We will see, and I know I'm kind of letting the cat out of the bag, but we will see him slip into some of his father's same sins and blind spots. But we see a big difference in Isaac, that he never takes another wife. He's true to one wife his entire life, and he only has children with her. He does not go off and try to take on concubines or something else. And so we see a faithfulness in Isaac that is different from his father Abraham. But today, I want to zero in on the fact that we see Abraham, yes, took another wife, but he kept Isaac in the position that God had called Isaac to, which was to be the heir. And so he gave gifts to his other children, but he sent those sons away to the east. Isaac alone sojourned alongside him in Canaan. And then we see that Abraham lived a long life. Now, there's a little bit more said, but I want to spend our next podcast episode really taking some time to think back through Abraham's life and kind of looking at the summary sentence Scripture gives about him and then his passing away. Father, I ask that you would help us to learn lessons as we see the contrasts between Abraham and Isaac. As we're journeying forward in Genesis, we're going to see how Isaac lives in light of how we've just studied how his father has lived. And we will see some similar blind spots that, Lord, you reveal in the scriptures, but we also see some major differences and some faithfulness and some consistency in Isaac in certain areas that his father was not. And I pray, Father, that we will be encouraged by that and that we will learn lessons as well about how our lives do impact our children, if you are, Lord, so gracious to give us children. But also, Father, we see that our lives as individuals are not, they do not have to be defined based on our parents' past and their failures and shortcomings. I pray you help us, Lord Jesus, to see your truth. In Jesus' name, amen.